Hello, it has been long. I haven't done anything on cosmology and time dilation. So this video is basically an attachment to the earlier videos, which I already had uploaded on YouTube. Okay. See, this video is again going to be in partition. It is not going to be like a complete course. Okay. And now in this session, we're going to understand how a black hole is forming and what are the intention and what are the principle of it. Okay. So let's understand it. So you see, there is this Earth surface. There is a person who is standing on the Earth surface. There is this Earth atmosphere and there is this space. So the intention of this person is to throw this tennis ball so high that it directly reaches to the space. I mean, this is a kind of funny thing, but this person's intention is very clear. He wants to throw this ball so high that it reaches to the space directly. Now, to do that, this is not simple, but there is this intention. Okay, so now he will throw this ball. You see here, it reaches to some height, but now the planet is having a gravitational force here. You see, there is a gravity. This gravity pull back this ball from the height and pull back to the ground. This is the problem, right? Why? Because the force that the person is applying to the tennis ball is merely very small compared to the gravitational force or the gravity of the Earth. Okay, and that's why it is pulling back to the Earth's surface. On the second case, he applies some more force. You see, it increases the height, but then again there is this problem. Gravitational force is so high that it pulls back the ball to the Earth's surface. But now in the third case, you understand that he applies some larger force than that of the compared to that of this gravitational force, and because of that reason, this ball, you know, have some velocity, get some good velocity, and he escapes the Earth atmosphere or the Earth gravitational pull, and it reaches to the space. So it escapes that gravity and reaches to the space directly. Why? Because as it applies some more force and it is having some good velocity, we call this velocity as escape velocity. And escape velocity is nothing but when you apply some good force, then that object is going to possess some velocity which crosses the gravitational pull of any planet and reaches directly to the space. The same principle applies to the satellite which is launched from the launch pad from the Earth's surface, and the rocket or the space shuttle is having thrusters to the Earth atmosphere. So it is having a larger force. You can see the larger force because I have some good thrusters, and that's why I initially get some good speed in terms of escape velocity, and that's why when it reaches to the exosphere, the thrusters gets detached from the main satellite, and now this satellite is in the space and roams freely without any thrusters, right? That's why we need some good force and the escape velocity. So this escape velocity is very, very important when we are dealing with black hole. You understand why it is important. I will give you a precise observation on that. So you see, as I'm talking about velocity, as the escape velocity is there with the ball, so definitely I have some kinetic energy, and as I'm possessing some height, so definitely I have some potential energy. So they are equal, okay? And so because of that reason, I have half mv square as kinetic energy and gmm divided by r as my potential energy. So when you rearrange this two formulas, you will get the v equals to 2gm divided by r or the square root of that. This is your escape velocity. This is the formula of escape velocity, where g is the gravitational constant of the Earth planet, m is the mass of the Earth, and r is the radius of the Earth. And there is this numerical calculation on that, and you can easily calculate the escape velocity of Earth, which is nothing but approximately 12 kilometers per second. So that means if you want to escape to the Earth, or you want to crosses the gravitational pull or the gravitational force of the Earth's surface, then you need 12 kilometers per second velocity to reaches to the space. You need that kind of speed, okay, which can be easily not easily get it, but you need this velocity, 12 kilometers per second. But now the very good observation is, so it says that we are talking about Earth, right? Earth is very small. But when I compare this Earth with a larger mass, let's say Sun. So this is my Earth and this is my Sun. You see, mass is very small here. But now the Sun mass is very, 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 very large. So the idea here is, if your mass is larger, then definitely the gravitational force or the gravity is very, very high. So your mass is very high, then your gravitational force is very high. And because of both these two reasons, I need a greater escape velocity. I need greater escape velocity. You understand? If your mass is very higher and your gravitational force is very higher, then I need very good escape velocity to crosses this pull and reaches to the space, right? So if I compare the Earth and Sun, then this is the criteria. But think about the star, or think about a planet which is larger than Sun, larger than kind of, let's say, neutrinos or a neutron star or pulsars, larger than that. Think about the case there. Mass is very higher, force is very higher, then I need a greater escape velocity. I need escape velocity greater than the speed of light. I need this condition. So I need, if my mass is very larger and my gravity is very larger, then I need escape velocity greater than speed of light, which is really very, very not possible. It is not possible for me to get the velocity or the speed of light in real time. I'm unable to do that right now. So if the larger the mass, larger the gravitational force, and because of that reason I need the escape velocity greater than speed of light. I'm talking about larger mass. Think about it. Okay, I don't need this condition when I'm comparing this particular condition to the Earth planet or the Jupiter or the Saturn. But when I compare this to pulsars or the neutron stars or the supernova, then I need this kind of condition. And precisely when I talking about black hole, then definitely I need this condition. Why? Because black hole mass is very, very higher, not higher, but the gravitational pull or the gravitational force is really very, very high. And because of that reason, I need the velocity greater than speed of light, which is not possible for me. And that's why the black hole are, kind of destruction. So this video comprises the escape velocity, just understand it. In the later session, I'm going to explain how black hole is completely related to the escape velocity and how it is important. I'm going to explain you in a very serial manner. And the complete source and the reference is being taken by a kind of a black hole and an introduction, a kind of